Does your business need to send out quotations? And does this seem to take ages to do? Well, if that's the case, then why not create your own quotation system template using an Excel spreadsheet so that you can automate the entire process? Hello and welcome to another Mr. Spreadsheet video. In this short presentation, we will create a quotation system using an Excel spreadsheet that includes a customer and a products or services database. The completed template is easy to use and can be either printed or saved as a PDF for you to email to your potential customers. The finished template uses many Excel functions, commands, and techniques. We will insert graphics and text boxes. We name ranges. We create a nested formula combining the concatenate and the XLOOKUP functions. And we format the final template for printing and email. All of these techniques are explained in the presentation. Now, if you would like to get a copy of the completed template, then all we ask is that you subscribe to our channel and give this video a big thumbs up. Okay, let's get started. In a new workbook, make sure that you have three worksheets and then name them Quotation, Customers and Products. Navigate to the Quotation worksheet and from the Page Layout ribbon, deselect the View Grid Lines box. Now, from the Insert ribbon, select the Illustrations tool and then the Icons tool, and from there I have selected the abacus icon. Now click on the Insert button. The icon now appears on your worksheet. With the icon still selected, pick up the Graphics Fill tool and choose light green from the color palette. From the Graphics Outline tool, select dark gray. Now resize the icon and place it roughly in the same position as shown on screen. Using this routine, you may wish to select an icon that is more suited to your business needs. Uncheck the icon and, from the Insert ribbon, select the Text option and then the Word Art option. Now, choose the Orange with Bold Outline style and, from the Text Fill palette, choose Light Green and, from the Outline palette, select Dark Green. Enter in your business name and then resize the text and then roughly place the text box to the position shown on screen. Deselect this text box and then create a new text box, but this time choose the ordinary text box style. Drag out a shape and enter in your business strapline or any other appropriate narrative. Make this green and place it directly below the business name as shown. Now create a third text box and enter in the word quotation. Make the text black and increase the font size and position it roughly as shown on screen. Highlight both of these two text boxes by clicking on each one of them whilst holding down the Shift key. Now right click your mouse and from the sidebar that opens select the Format Shape tool. From the Format Shape dialog box that opens, look for the Line option and then select No Line. This eliminates the borders from our text boxes. Okay, that's the graphics and the text boxes sorted. We can now move on to create the other elements in our quotation document. Highlight the range N8 through to N9 and from the Home ribbon, choose the Merge and Center tool. Enter in the number of 1035, make this bold and increase the font size. Highlight the range D10 through to N10 and from the Borders tool on the Home ribbon select the bottom border. In cells D11 through to N11, enter in the quotation headings of Code, Product, Quantity, Price, and total. format the text to a mid-green and make bold. That's great. Our quotation header is done. Let's quickly create the quotation footer. Select the range D26 through to N26, and from the Borders tool, select this time the Top Border option. Merge and center the range D27 through to N27, and enter in the business contact details as shown. We can now create our two databases, one for our customer details and the other for our product details. Firstly, on the products worksheet, copy in the data as shown, and please use the same coordinates starting in cell B4. You can pause the video whilst you complete this process. Now, let's move to the customers worksheet. In the range C3 through to J3, copy in the customers table headings as shown, and then copy in your first line of data. Highlight the range C3 through to J25, and from the Insert ribbon, pick up the Insert Table tool. Make sure that the My Table Has Headers box is checked, and then choose a table color style to your liking. And finally, copy in the three customer records as shown. Okay, that's great. We can now return to the quotation worksheet and create the formulae to help us automate the quotation process. In cell D12, enter in the value W101. We want both the product description and the price to be retrieved directly from the products table. We can use the XLOOKUP command to do this. The XLOOKUP command will call on the stock code, the product description, and the price columns in the products database. So let's quickly give a name to these three ranges. On the products worksheet, highlight the range B4 through to D23. And from the formulas ribbon, select the Create from Selection option. Make sure that the top line option is the only box checked, and then click OK to save and close. Navigate back to the quotation worksheet, and with cell E12 selected, enter in the formula equals XLOOKUP open brackets, point to cell D12, enter a comma, the word stock code followed by a comma, and the word product, and now close the brackets. E12 should populate correctly with a description of widgets grey. Now skip a few columns across to cell L12 and enter in a quantity of 5. And in M12 we can enter in our second XLOOKUP command, which becomes equals XLOOKUP open brackets, point to cell D12, enter in a comma, then the word stock code, followed by a comma, and then the word price, and close the brackets. This should return product 101's price of 17.56. And finally, on the first row, let's enter in the line total in cell N12. The formula is simply L12 times M12 to give a line value of 87.80. Now with the range D12 through to N12 highlighted, copy and drag down the formulas through to cell N22. You can check that all the values have been correctly retrieved and calculated correctly. Now auto-sum the total value column in cell N24. Increase the font size and make this bold. And in cell K24, enter the narrative, total quote value, and then copy in my cell formatting. Move to cell D24 and enter in the formula equals today, open brackets, close brackets. This will retrieve the current date. in cell E24, enter in a suitable narrative containing the sender's details. Format D24 and E24 in a matching green text. Make bold and resize as necessary. And finally, we need to enter the contact details and salutations for the quote's recipient. Go to cell C9 and enter in the code A101. A101 is the code for our customer, ABC Limited, whose details are in the customer's database. Now, move across to cell D9. We're going to use a combination of the XLOOKUP command and the CONCATENATE command to create an automated salutation. Firstly, as before, let's name the ranges that our XLOOKUP command will use. Select the customer's worksheet and highlight the range C4 through to C25. Now type in the word code in the name box just to the left of the insert function tool. Do the same with the range D4 through to D25, and in the name box call this name. And with E4 through to E25 highlighted, give this a name of contact. Return to the quotation worksheet and in cell D9 type in the formula equals concatenate open brackets inverted comma the word to followed by a colon then a space and an inverted comma then a comma XLOOKUP open brackets point to C9 comma the word code comma the word contact and close the brackets, then enter a comma, then an inverted comma, then a space, the word at, then a space, then an inverted comma, followed by a comma, XLOOKUP, open brackets, C9, comma, code, comma, name, close brackets, and a final closing brackets. This formula joins together the salutation of to and then picks up your contact's name of Joe Cooper from the customer's database, then adds the word at, and then finally retrieves the customer's business name again from the customer's database. Now select cell C9 and change the font color to white such that the contents are not visible. This nested formula is reasonably complex and some users may simply want to just type in a salutation of their own. Let me know in the comments section below which you prefer. Let's put a border around the whole document. Highlight the range C2 through to O28 and from the Borders tool select Outside Borders. Play around with the formatting and positioning of the graphics to ensure that the completed template looks presentable. Finally, let's set the document's printing coordinates. Select File from the menu bar at the top of your screen, and then choose Print. In the Print dialog box that opens, click on the Page Setup link. From this, check the Change the Scaling option to fit to one page, or indeed choose a scaling and a page layout to your liking. You can now send your output directly to the printer, or save as a PDF for emailing. If you do choose to email, then please make sure that you save the PDF with a unique reference. And that completes our work. We now have an easy-to-use template with which we can send professional-looking quotations to our customers. We do hope that you enjoyed watching this video and that there was lots of content that you found both useful and informative. If you would like a copy of this spreadsheet template, then please do subscribe to our channel and give this video a big thumbs up. You can also visit us on one of our channels, on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. Now, if you are a small business and you want to keep your accounting records using a spreadsheet, then why not watch our How to Keep Your Accounts in Excel video? And if you would like to get a copy of this quotation spreadsheet, then please watch our free Mr. Spreadsheet Templates video. Thank you once again for watching.